Hygiene is not treating the teeth, it's preventing the future treatment. Today you have all the possibilities, all the tools for proper hygiene treatment, and the cost of these tools is also quite low. You can buy electric toothbrush for $30, $20. Very low amount, and it enhances the quality of the toothbrushing very much. It's recommended by almost every dentist. So you have all the toothpastes, you have dental floss, you have all the things. You just need to do this and to want to do this and to see that you're doing the right thing.
It's not like in the Stone Age when you need to go to the river and choose some wood.
Exactly. It's very easy. You have all the options. You can buy them. They're available in every place. Today you buy, you go to buy vegetables and there you can see toothbrushes for sale. Just do this and you'll probably won't have any problems if you're doing it correctly.
So the first step is preventing.
Exactly.
I think the second step is going to a doctor.
Yeah. There are still things that you can 100% prevent. So you do need to go for checkups, for follow-ups, for dental routine treatments, like going to dental hygienist to clean the teeth for proper, deeper cleaning. Because there are things that it's not that easy to clean in-house. So once every half a year, for example, go to a doctor, a dental hygienist. He'll look at your teeth, tell you if everything's fine, if you need to do something. And this way, with proper treatments, preventable treatments, you won't have any tooth filling at all.
This is the intraoral scanner.
Yeah, no, it's a big leap between this and that. Last, for example, 10 years, there is a big leap in digital technologies in dentistry. So today we're using less and less materials like the silicone that we used in the mouth. And we more and more using digital technologies and 3D scanner, some kind of animations showing the patient what he'll have before we're making it, giving the patient the option to decide, to choose between different types of treatments. You can do this more and more because you have some kind of digital technologies.
So digital technologies assisted doctors by making the procedures much easier, much more user-friendly.
Yeah.
But how it affected the patients? That the procedure itself is easier for the patient, it's less traumatic?
First of all, yeah, it's a little less easier because I have some patients with a gag reflex, for example, and extreme gag reflex that probably every doctor have. It can be a nightmare to take impressions because the patient can't withstand the silicone material. In these cases, the intraoral scanner is amazing. Sometimes with the intraoral scanner, you need to take less time impressions. You can, instead of taking the whole jaw, you can just take a portion of the jaw. It makes the treatment much less annoying, much less inconvenient.
This intraoral scanner and all the digital age, we see every doctor, a lot of doctors market themselves as they can do a restoration in one day. Is this a lie or is it possible?
Now, with the new technologies, of course, you have the ability to make the works much faster. So today, there are patients that I can make the whole jaw in one day, take impressions, and the next day I have the complete work. It's not always the right thing to do. because even though you can do something, doesn't mean that you always need to do that. There are cases when you need to wait, you need to wait for proper healing, you need to wait for the biological factors. The technology can't make healing much faster. You still need to give it a couple of weeks. But yes, you can today making some aesthetical solutions, some minor problems right away or in the same day or maybe in the next day, and you'll see the results will be quite good, something that you couldn't do before. Today, we're not sending a patient without a frontal tooth home.
What about types of restorations? Cemented, screw retained? You can do all of this with the intraoral scanner in the digital way?
With the digital new solutions that you have, the work of the dentist is much more precise. With this precision, we can start using different kinds of technologies that we were afraid using before. Because before, if you had a big bridge for the full jaw, there was some concern in taking impressions. You weren't sure that you'll take impressions and the final work will fit. So in many cases, you chose to separate in the bridge into three or four pieces, or you chose to make a cement restoration, even though it's not the best possible way for this type of work. Today, we're using more and more screw-retained restorations because screw-retained, for proper screw-retained restoration, you need to have a high accuracy. When you have good accuracy with the new technologies, you can even very hard cases make screw-retained, like all the all-on-fours that you hear, many different cases that you have. You're making them screw-retained. This way, you can screw the restoration into the mouth and unscrew it when you need to check, to fix, or to have any adjustments to the restoration themselves.
Why to wait for a month if there are doctors that says that you can do it in one day?
You just need to give the biology its time. When you place an implant, one single implant, in place that you don't see, that you don't need immediate aesthetic solution, that you can wait a little bit. It would be probably better to place the implant and wait this amount of time and wait till the implant will heal and then you'll have a good restoration. When you apply too much force on the implant that didn't heal properly, the body can reject the implant. It's something that you don't want. You always have this risk.
And the follow-up procedure in this age of the cadcam and the intraoral scanner is much easier also, right? All the information is saved. If something happens...
First of all, you don't need to save all the models, all the gypsum models that we used to save. You have everything digital. All the information you took, it's like on the cloud. You can always access it. And you can always see what was, what's now.
So if a patient breaks, let's say, his bridge, he comes to you, you see the latest model you designed for him and just print it again?
Yeah, it's one of the greatest things that happened, because now if the patient has some temporary restoration and the patient broke the restoration, he calls me or calls the clinic, he says that I broke this, I just mill it again, and he comes, I screw the new one, and that's all.
It saves like 3 appointments.
Yeah, something like this.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, follow us to stay tuned with the latest cases. Have a great day.